gross. Okay, I'm not gonna bore you with the rest of this gooey crap. I'm just gonna clean it all out and see what.
What a lovely workbench I have here. So, next step is starting to install these brass plugs. These are drain plugs that go down on the bottom of the
side of the engine block.
So you're at the end of the year, you
pull these open, drain all the water out. Part number on these is 22-806608.
Yeah, just listen to the audio. These are the brass plugs that go into the engine block. From Mercury, I don't know if these are the original O-rings or not, but
they come with these chintzy little skinny things.
I bought these bigger ones. What I ended up buying were
from Home Depot.
O-rings. They're 11/16 inch by 7/16 inch by 1/8 inch tall. Buna rubber. So these will have no problem sealing this. This is the little difference that I like to show you.
You grab the plugs here.
These do look dirty as hell, but I did clean them off. Take the little skinny one here, you
put it on.
That's like barely fitting in there. And I grab some bigger O-rings. Put these guys on.
Fits much, much better.
So the factory skinny little O-rings. Screw it in. There's like barely any sealing in there. I don't like that. So I put the big O-rings on there. Plenty of thread engagement. Then you give it a squeeze and
yeah, that's solidly tight and engaged.
Look at the difference there. This is the thicker ones that I got and chintzy factory ones. So this does have a little groove that they're supposed to fit into. But if you want to see what happens to them over time, come out and look like a flat donut looking thing.
All right, so we are going to be converting an automotive engine block to a marine engine block. So we're an automotive motor has an oil drain plug that goes into the side of the block here. Marine motors only use the oil dipstick like we talked about in the last video. So at the depot of homeless people, we get a square head plug, 1/8 MIP plug here, brass pipe plug. We're tapping the hole here where normally it would just squish in with an O-ring in an automotive application. And we're using some compressed, right now we got the engine block upside down, so any filings will be falling out this way. In addition to that, we've taken some masking tape. We taped off the oil filter. We taped off the front crank. We taped off the PCV holes on both sides. And we're going to be running compressed air, so anything that comes up free is going to be getting blown through this. So we're going to continue tapping it. And then I'll show you putting the brass plug in afterwards. So that's the air nozzle that we're using. And you can already see some of the grit coming out and pooling under here. So here's your filings as it's coming out. So this is working really good. Starting to tap. See some more filings in there. Hit that air real quick again. See if anything comes out. Oh yeah. Kill it for a minute. Get this tap back in there. Don't cross thread, don't cross thread, even though it's the best kind of thread lock.
So you try to get it out.
I know. Ah, this is looking horrible for the YouTubers. All right, now we're threaded in there. Alright, we're catching all of this crap with that air thing that's going. Here, while I finish pulling this out, keep blowing.
Probably dinner first.
Look at all that smooth. Now that she's tapped, I plugged my finger there and we used the air gun and blew the rest of the schmoo out. A little bit of schmoo left. Moment of truth, if this little boy fits, there's a girl.
Come on.
Oh yeah, like a glove. Woo! And then just get snug as it gets up there. Oh, it's gonna be perfect. So we're gonna put some Loctite on this. Throw that bad Larry back in and another project done. The only other thing I've got to plug left is the top of this engine block being a 090M code, casting code. I don't have what the correct thread is on this yet. You know, I tried one of these brass plugs, but it's just too big. So I'm gonna have to find the right size there. That looks dirty. Oh, it's all covered in water. So what happens when you get a kerosene heater going and cold steel iron, cast iron, condensates. Right. Loctite's on. Look at that red schmoo. I mean, there's red schmoo all over. Spent about $800 on all the new electronics for this thing this afternoon on the good old Zahn of the Amis. This is not going to have to be too tight because this is a cast iron block. I'm not freaking filming anything. And a brass plug. And literally all this is doing is like an oil drain plug, just a cap. Yep, that's probably all we need. Finished product. Dun, da, da, da. Now it's a marine motor. Alright, new painted shiny black parts. Motor mounts. The crank pulley. Timing flywheel thingy-majiggy. Yeah, you can see the timing marks here. Before top dead center. 12.84 degrees, after top dead center, 4 degrees and a little hard to read, but fun part after paint job is always tearing off that tape. A little hard to do one-handed. Oh yeah. Here we go. Ready to go back on. Got some more bolts all painted up. Here we are installing the motor mounts. Okay. All 9/16 hardware. So your studs, you got a long side and a short side. The long side goes through and you use that much for the thread, and then the short side for the seawater pump and stuff that bolts onto the outside here. So these are gonna go up. Two bolts on the top, one on the bottom. I'll just start them a little bit. Power tools. Let's give a little up pressure on this one so when it goes in, all the weight of that is going to be up against the block. Nice and tight. And then the nuts I'm just going to thread on by hand. They'll stay there till I'm ready to put the seawater pump on. Now the port side doesn't have the studs, it just has three bolts. I believe this wire loom goes up like this somehow. I think these wires come to the front of the motor. There's no way for the wire loom to go down to the bottom because then wires wouldn't go through. So
It's on.
Okay, now the only place that these things could leak is coming right down the keyway from the center. So you want to make sure you put some RTV in there. Goopy goopy goop. Probably a little too much. You see. Yeah, whatever. That's enough. Some more goopy goop. Come on, goopy. It's cold in here. This goopy goop doesn't want a goopy goop. Okay, that's done.
Take your keyway. Line it up with the keyway that's on there. And get a mallet, rubber mallet. Okay, we smacked it down and got some thread engagement. Oh yeah, she goes. Check this out. I can tell that's bottomed out. From here, I'm going to go get the front pulley. Now, once the bolt has pulled that in, you got to pull the bolt back out. When you pull the bolt out, the flywheel's not going to come. Not the flywheel, the timing thing won't come. Because that's kind of pressed on there now. Ooh, look at all the goopy goop. Nice. Forgot about that schnyuck. All right. Now the pulley goes over the top. I kind of want to line up three bolt holes that hold the pulley on. And this goes over the top of them. So you can see here. So you got your 1, 2, and 3 bolt holes. This middle one goes in. Before that one goes crazy tight, let me grab the other little bolts that hold on this pulley. I don't have all the correct terminology. This is a pulley. It's a crank pulley. The part in the back is like your timing pulley. Two. Need one more in my pocket. 3. Oh, today in Rhode Island it is cold. I mean, it's going to get colder, but I think it's supposed to get down to about 12 degrees tonight. Woo. Now I can whack this middle one. I really don't need to whack it back on there with the impact gun because the impact did it. Just to pull it in. Well, whatever. I'll zap it. That's tight. Guten tight. Oh, I just got shit in my eyes. Awesome. So you see it's nice and tight up in there. See some timing marks. That's how you install your crank pulley.
All right, we got motor mounts on, front crank on. What's next? I think we start from the bottom and work our way up, so. Down on the bottom corner over here, we got seawater pumps. So I wrote in, and this is out. That's in, that's out. I think I wrote that on there. But the way that this bracket bolts on, you gotta pay attention. So,
What? Oh, shoot. I took one bolt out already. This one went in there. So is this pump symmetrical? No, it's not. We got two bolts and a V over here. And then three bolts on this side. If I go by the words being upright, that might make it easier. So when the words are upright, three bolts on the bottom, hose on the right is out, hose on the left is in, and the bracket will bolt to the top side.
Here's the main seawater pump. It's got little initials in there.
Excuse me, burp. SWP, seawater pump. Don't mind the PB blaster, I just squirted on this. I'm gonna be pressing this pulley out. Cause
this is awfully crunchy sounding. So I'm thinking the bearings definitely gotta get replaced in here. Little drain hole in the bottom. Thinking that's probably where water drains out. Maybe that's the one where water drains out. Because probably gets new bearings or something in there. So here's the old seawater pump impeller. Tell it's got all these cracks. This thing was definitely worn. Even on all the fan or the fins. See all them marks. This was ready to fail. I'm definitely gonna press this apart. See if I can find bearings online first. Can't find bearings and new seals, then I'm gonna have to buy new seawater pumps. As I was cleaning it, you can tell that there's a seal in the back. That's all junkerooed. Doesn't even look centered. I don't know if it's supposed to be or not. But we're gonna pull it apart and find out.
No idea this is gonna work. But we're gonna try it. It's bending the pulley. Put my safety glasses. I have a feeling I'm gonna end up buying a new freaking seawater pump. These are really designed to be pulled from crank, not from the outside of this. It's gonna break something. Oh, that's pushing that pulley straight through. Oh, I
wired that.
This used to be flat. And now look at it. It's all worked to shit. We already fucked it up, right? Might as well just go for broke.
I hate this shit. Yep, broke the pulley.
That's the first major fail of this entire endeavor. Every bolt has come out without breaking.
This is why you're supposed to use the right tool for the job.
It still doesn't come off. Imagine if all I had to do was put it the other way and push the whole thing out. Should we try it? Since we fucked it up anyway?
That's a yes. Okay. Steve, you think it's gonna come out?
You give it about a 20% chance of success.
I like those odds.
12 tons of harbor freight hack job.
I'm backing up now.
Why didn't I just start it from this side to begin with? What the fuck? Because I'm guessing that's how you're supposed to pop it out. There was no saving this. I definitely needed a new one. Holy crap. That bearing was gone.
That used to be a bearing?
I think this used to be a bearing. Maybe. Yeah, that's a race. Like where ball bearings are supposed to ride inside? Well, I don't even know if I can save the shaft. Oh, look at this. So I guess what's supposed to happen is when you pull the pulley off, you even got a snap ring in here that's probably supposed to come off before the whole thing gets pushed out. But this was so corroded away, there's actually two bearing races there. One and two, and yeah, both of those are gone. My God, nasty. Well, now that I got everything apart, I can pull the rest of this stuff off with the press. Maybe, just maybe, I could save the shaft, save the housing, put new bearings and seals in it, and not spend $400. But there's seals in here, because this little spring used to be part of a seal. Wow, that is called seawater pump failure. All right, here's what's left of a couple ball bearings that came out of it. That one's not very bally anymore. That one's a little bally. I have no idea where the rest of them went. Probably rotted away. So what we're gonna do is try to press from here, keep continuing to push the collar of the pulley off. Maybe we can salvage the shaft and we might be able to get some new bearings and seals and not have to completely buy a new one. Yeah, these things are like $300 or $400 for, I don't know why they're so expensive, but they are. The washer flat. Ah, I hate when that happens. Well, that's coming out. I thought this was like a thrust washer or something. That was a seal. That was one of the outer O-ring seals.
Whoops.
So I have to back the bolt out some. Oh, even that bolt's not even centered. It's like the head of the bolt's off center. What's that made in China? RBI, runner battered in bolt. All right, is this press number four?
I lost count.
Oh yeah, now it's coming right out.
So here's your shaft of the main seawater pump. Obviously made out of stainless steel and not rusted. I don't know what I'm gonna have to do to get, well, there's that collar. That was a bearing collar. I wonder if I can press this one off. So you've got a bearing collar on this side and a bearing collar on that side. Not much left of it. Made of plastic? I don't even know if it's plastic or metal. Eric.
So here's the seawater pump drive shaft. Looking for damage. This is pretty pitted. I don't think anything rides on this surface. This surface had a bearing. So it came down and it got pressed onto there. And this is the side that the pulley goes onto. And this is the surface that the other bearing rides on. But what's funky is that it's got this lip. If the other bearing collar pushes down and goes over that, how do they get it over that lip? Unless right in this ridge right here, so the flat surface bump up and that little gap, I'm guessing there was a C-clip or something.
Schmoo that came out of it. A couple more ball bearings. These were your races. Let's go see what we can pull out of this thing.
I don't know what that C-clip was holding in. I thought I could just look at the exploded diagram online. I think that's what I'm going to do before I go yank all this apart and make a giant mess. Alright, so I just used my snap ring pliers and loosened this up. That's the snap ring that comes out. Apparently there are rebuild kits online. Look at all this schmoo. So determine this housing is no good. I'm gonna have to buy a new one. I was actually playing like a dentist. I was going in and just chewing away at the sidewall. This is all galvanic corrosion, or just regular corrosion from saltwater ingestion. And then looking down inside, all the way around, it's pretty horrible. I would never get a good seal, even if I put a new seal in here. Even at the sidewall, you don't have good sound metal. You know, right here, there's some good metal where it would seal, but then like, start going up around the edges, it's like, yeah. You can see the holes that I dug out here. And then the other side, these are the bearing races still in here. I was whacking these with a mallet from the other side, you know, coming up, trying to drive them out that way. But then even where the snap ring fits in, in that gap, it's not salvageable. Well, this thing is destroyed. See, even on the inside, come in. Even all up in here, this is just gone. I mean, the inside isn't too important. It's like where the bearing races bolt in. So this is the old bearing race, towards the front of it. Front of the motor, and this is the old bearing race in the rear that I still can't get out. Like, even whacking with a mallet, I still can't get it out. So unfortunately I'm gonna have to be spending a lot of money. New seawater pump is like $300 something. Rebuild kits are cheaper, but I can't even salvage this housing. You know, maybe if I put a lot of silicone around the edge when I drove the seals in. But I don't like all of that material that's just gone. Who knows how far away from the wall that is. It doesn't feel like it's very thick.
can't believe these things are so freaking expensive. Nasty.
First unsalvageable part. We tried.
To end the video on a good note, P, port. Pull the port one apart. This one still has some bearings, so at least something's saved. So this one, we can save. I'm gonna buy new bearings and seals for this one. And hopefully, this one will save. I'm gonna buy a real puller to get this off and save the pulley. But the other one's gonna come with a new pulley anyway. So, good one, bad one. I also did a little reading that these drain holes are like weep holes. So when the pump starts to fail, or when the seals fail, it leaks seawater in here. And then it fills your bilge up with seawater. That's not good. Your boat can sink that way. I mean, a little tiny pinhole would take a while, but. All right, one salvageable seawater pump. Time to rebuild those. Ah, more parts. Probably add another couple of days onto the rebuild. I have 104 days left before I can put the boat on the mooring. I think I can make it with all these parts. I don't know.